For me, it was a normal day. He didn't want to affect me. I went to work. I said goodbye. I was running late for work. I said goodbye to him. He was in the house like he is normally for the day because he works at night. And I finally came home from work that night, and he sat me down and he told me. He said, something happened at work. And I said, okay. I said, is it serious? And he said, yeah. He says, unfortunately, I had to take a life. And I said, okay. And I asked him what happened. And he said, he couldn't really get into the details of it. He said, but he had to shoot his weapon. And I said, okay. And I said, did you do your job? And he said, yes. And I said, did you do what you were trained to do? And he said, yes. And the entire time I was talking to him, he was crying, I was crying, we were sitting next to each other on the couch, and that's all I asked him. I said, did you do what you were trained to do? And he said, absolutely. And I said, okay, we'll go from there. I personally didn't watch the video until about 6 months ago. I didn't want to see it. I had strong feelings against the video for the simple fact that, not about my husband, but the fact that it's a loss of life. Nobody needs to see that. It's a tragedy. And I was disgusted the fact that all of the media outlets were just blasting it constantly, so everybody could see someone lose their life. I mean, it always has affected us. Did we think it was gonna come to this magnitude? No. We knew he did his job, but the day they stripped him and sent him out, took his star and his basically his dignity away from him from doing his job, that was devastating. I was really upset and frustrated with the fact that everybody kept portraying him as one person, this one person, that he was a racist, trigger-happy cop. And that's not who he is. That's never who he's been, and it's never who he never will be.